So this is Mansi from Java Techies. Today I have made a small demo for a particular project, that is a Spring Boot simple project. Here I'm going to demo the scheduling along with this timer task thing. So I'll go into details one by one. So first of all, we will go for scheduling. I'll explain what is scheduling and then we'll move on to timer task. So scheduling is nothing but it is a process of executing the task for a specific time of period. So as soon as you, like in your applications, you have some kind of requirement, okay, I have to clean up something, you know, continuously, or I have to clean up something, or I have to execute a task, suppose in every, you know, 7 days or every day at this particular point of time. So such kind of a requirement can be actually done using the schedulers that are provided by the Spring Boot. So these schedulers actually run at regular period of time. That period of time is configurable. Whatever you provide, it will take it as that, and it will run continuously. You can provide your code as part of it. So I'll just show you how to configure a scheduler. So this is my application class. You just have to include this @enableScheduling annotation for enabling the scheduling. And apart from this, you will have to create a class of yours. Like I have created a scheduler job. You can create any class based on your requirement. And then you have to use this @scheduled annotation. This is basically for defining a particular scheduler. And with this, you can specify a set of parameters. I'll go into details one by one. So with this @scheduled annotation, you have to actually specify your method, which will necessarily have a return type as void. And inside that, you can write your own logic, whatever you want to execute as part of that scheduler. So here I have just given a simple system.out.println statement. You can write your own business logic, whatever you want. So here, if you talk about the parameters, you can see here it is fixed delay, and I have given, so this is in milliseconds. So this is approximately 1 second. I'll just first run this so that you get an idea about it. So you can say my application has started. And now I'm getting this log. This means that this scheduler is running periodically within 1 second. That is 1000 milliseconds. You can see the difference, right? It's running every second. I've printed the time period also here. So this scheduler I have configured this time. You can configure based on your requirement. So now I'll just explain you what is this fixed delay. So we have multiple parameters that we can provide along with @scheduled annotation. One of them is fixed delay. So fixed delay will actually, you know, it as soon as multiple tasks get executed as part of scheduler. So fixed delay will wait for the previous task to complete, and then only it will start the new task after that delay period. That is, fixed delay actually makes sure that there is a delay of n milliseconds between finish time of an execution of task and the start time of the next execution of task. Now here I have provided it as 1. I'll just try to configure it. Let me get it to 3, for example. I'll just save it. Now you can see it will now get into 3. Like see, it is 38, now 41, and then 44. So you can see now the scheduler is running with a fixed delay of 3 seconds. Now coming on to the next parameter, that is initial delay. So suppose this fixed delay actually is the frequency of execution of task, and initial delay will actually work once. That is the first time your scheduler will execute. So it will delay with this amount of time. Now suppose I give it as 5, you will be able to see that it starts, the scheduler starts after 5 seconds. We just save it. So you can see it is taking time. Here it is, the seconds is 24, and here it is 29. right? And after that, scheduler is running periodically within a time period of 3 seconds, as I have specified here. So this is what initial delay is. Now coming on to the next thing, that is fixed rate. Like here you have provided fixed delay. Similarly, you can provide it as like this, fixed rate. You can provide whatever time period, that is again into milliseconds only. So that if now there is a very commonly asked question in most of the interviews, what is the difference between fixed delay and fixed rate? So as I already mentioned, fixed delay actually runs at regular period of time. It makes sure that there is a delay of n seconds between the finish time of an execution of previous task and the start time of execution of next task. That is, it waits for the previous task to complete. After that, it will have that n number of seconds that you have provided, and then only the next task is going to execute. Now, fixed rate. What is fixed rate? Fixed rate actually, doesn't wait for the previous task completion. So, fixed rate property runs a scheduled task at every n milliseconds. It does not check for any previous executions of the task that is in use. So fixed rate is actually useful in cases when all your tasks are independent. So we do not care if the previous one was completed or not at this particular point of time. We want the next one to get executed for sure. In that case, we are going to go for fixed rate. Now, coming on to the next one, you can also provide cron. So you have heard about cron jobs and cron expressions. So you can also provide like this, something like this here. Cron equals to and your expression. You can also provide the zone like Europe and Paris. So according to this expression, we are actually scheduling the task to be executed at 10:15 a.m. on every 15th day of a month, according to the time zone of Paris. So like this, you can schedule your jobs to run. You can provide any kind of cron expression into it, or fixed delay, fixed rate. So like that, you can configure and schedule your jobs. Now let's move on to the timer task. Let me just comment this out so that I can explain you what is a timer task in a better way. So this is my class custom timer task that extends the timer task. So I'll just go through first what is timer task. So timer task, so this is entire thing is there in java.util package. So timer task is also used to execute a particular task in as a background thread. So with timer task, you have the flexibility if you want to execute it once or you want to execute it repeated number of times. Like you saw in scheduler, it was getting executed repeatedly unless you forcefully stop it. But with timer task, you have the flexibility if you want to execute it only once or you want to execute it repeatedly. Apart from that, for creating a timer task, we need to extend this timer task class. So this is an abstract class which has a run method into it. So timer task is used to perform a particular task, and there is a timer class as well which behaves as a scheduler. So we have to define a task that can be scheduled to run once or repeated number of times that can be done using the timer. So you can see here this timer task I have overridden. You have to override the run method to provide your own functionality. Again here I have just simply logged one statement. This is my custom timer task and the time around with that and the count, that number of times it has been executed. So into this run, so I'll come to this rest timer.cancel later. So for now let's just go through it. And I have this I will execute it from the main method. So what I have done is I have simply created here my object of util class, and I am calling this particular method first, timer task with delay. So how to do it? I have created my custom timer class object. What I am doing is now I am using the timer object. So I am creating timer object, and inside the parameters I am providing it as true. This means that this timer thread will actually run as a daemon thread, which will run as a background thread, you can say. So, and I am scheduling that particular task, my task that I created, which had the run method here in the timer. I am scheduling that particular task, and with that you can provide the initial delay. So this is again the initial delay parameter that we saw as part of scheduler. So what happens is, when you do something like this, so the run method gets implicitly invoked when timer object schedules it to do so. Fine. So, and apart from that, timer class is also thread safe, and multiple timer threads can actually be shared by single timer object. You need not to worry about that without the need of any kind of external synchronization actually. So let's just try this. So what I did was, I'm calling this particular method, which is actually creating my custom timer object. And apart from the custom task object and creating a timer object, which is set as daemon or background task, and I am scheduling it to run with an initial delay of 0. So I'll just run this now. So this will get run only once, you can see here. So this is my timer task, and there is the count 1, because this is non-repeatable. I am not configuring anything which is actually repeatable. I just gave it an initial delay. I didn't give it any frequency onto which it has to execute repeatedly. So suppose I increase this initial delay to 5 seconds. So let's see if it works. Yeah, you can see right now it didn't give me that log. It will take approximately 5 seconds to be executed. Yeah, you can see the time difference, right? So it took 5 seconds to execute this. So like this, you can provide the initial delay as part of it. And this task will be executed only once. And you can actually control at the time you execute this particular task. Now, apart from this, we also have, suppose I want to execute, some task at a particular, period of time on a specific date. Okay, it got executed. So I'll just show you how. So I've created a method for this. What I'm doing again, I created my custom timer task object and the timer object. And what I did was, I took the local date time. So the current time I took, and I added 3 seconds to it. Okay, and then I am just providing this after 3 seconds, this schedule. I am scheduling it. It also takes the date. If you check the method arguments, so it also takes the task along with date. Previous one was this long delay. So I have provided the date as today with 3 seconds later. So you can see I first logged this current time. So this current time turned out to be this. And then I gave it the date, today's date, with 3 seconds later. So you can see after 3 seconds, it actually executed and implicitly invoked that run method with the date. You can also provide date, like I can provide a date 1 week after today. So like that, it is a completely depends on your requirement. This task will get executed once. Now, moving on to the next one. So now I'll show how to execute tasks repeatedly with timer task. So this is my method that I have created for repeated task execution. Now, see, I have created again the custom task object, and I have done this timer thing. And what I've done is, I have scheduled, and now in this method, I have provided the task along with the delay. And now this is the frequency of execution of that task. So this task will get executed after every 1 second. Again, it is specified in milliseconds. This task will get executed after every 1 second. So let's just try running it. Let me just save it. So you can see now with timer task, it is executing every second, right? Now suppose I give it as for example, not every second, I give it as every 5 seconds. Yeah, so now you are able to see it is executing after every 5 seconds. Now there is also an option to stop this. I mentioned at that time, I will just come back to this thing. So suppose a timer task is executing repeatedly and on some condition you want to stop that particular timer task, so you can use this timer.cancel method for that. So what happens, as soon as this method gets called, the timer task that has been executing repeatedly on the frequency that has been provided by you will actually stop its execution. So if you see, I am counting, I am having a count variable which is incrementing every time when this run method is getting called. Now after the count comes to 20, I am simply doing a timer.cancel. That means after 20 it will stop its execution. Now let's just configure that. I think I have taken the time as 5 seconds, which will be more. I'll just give the delay as 1 only. Okay, so now let's just try executing it. So after 20 it should ideally stop. Timer.cancel should be invoked and this timer should stop automatically. Yeah, so now you can see after 20 times it got executed, it actually went to that if condition, and using the timer.cancel method that is there into the timer class, you can stop this particular execution, repeated execution that is happening again and again. So this is how you can configure your own timer tasks or schedulers by yourself. So I think this is what I had. I will push all this code to the GitHub repo. I'll share the link along with the video, and you can simply go through that. And if you have some questions, I'll be happy to answer. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.